This is the sorry Christmas tale of Ebenezer Scrooge and how he discovered the true spirit of Christmas. But oh, at what cost the pitiful miser learned his lesson. And let this be a lesson to us all, that Christmas does not come in a parcel, an Amazon box, or a hamper from Ben's independent grocery, but from our hearts and not our pockets.
Oh, but he was a tight-fisted, hand-at-the-grindstone Scrooge. A squeezing, wrenching, grasping, scraping, clutching coveter's old sinner. Hard and sharp as flint, from which no steel had ever struck out generous fire. Secret and self-contained, solitary as an oyster. The cold within him froze his old features, nipped his pointed nose, trimmed his cheek, stiffened his gait, made his eyes red, his thin lips blue, and spoke out shrewdly in his grating voice. A frosty rind was on his head and on his eyebrows and on his wiry chin. He carried his own low temperature always about him. He iced his office in the dog days and didn't thaw it 1 degree at Christmas. External heat and cold paid little influence on Scrooge. No warmth could warm him, no wintry weather chill him, no wind that blew was bitterer than he. No falling snow was more intent from its purpose. No pelting rain less open to entreaty. Foul weather didn't know where to have him. The heaviest rain and snow and hail and sleet could boast of the advantage over him in only one respect. They often came down handsomely. Scrooge never did.
Ah! Humbug! Put another coal on the fire, they said. Fill up a bag for the less fortunate, they said. Give 5 ringgit to wear different clothes. Merry Christmas! What reason have you to be merry? What right have you to be merry? You're poor enough. Merry Christmas. What can I be but angry when I'm surrounded with a world of fools such as this? Merry Christmas. Out on your Merry Christmas. What's Christmas to you but a time for paying bills without any money? A time for finding yourself a year older, but not an hour richer. A time for having every item through a round dozen of your books presented dead against you, If I had my will, everyone, every fool who went around with Merry Christmas on his lips would be boiled in his own pudding. And be buried with a stake of holly through his heart.
I am the ghost of Christmas past. I am the ghost of all your guilt.
Long past.
I am the ghost of all your guilt. Your snubs, your pretend haven't seen. For you had a sister who you loved, Scrooge, and a girlfriend who longed to marry you, but you pushed them all away. You fear the world too much. All your other hopes merged into the hope of being beyond the chance of its sordid reproach. I saw your nobler aspirations fall off one by one, until the master passion, gain, engrossed you. When you loved, you were another man. And when you are now, Scrooge, but a worshipper of the false idol, the golden god, money.
What have we here in the present? You seem to need some Christmas cheer. I'm the ghost of Christmas present. Look upon me. The walls and the ceiling are so high. suddenly living green that it looked like a perfect rose. Brightly invested berries glistened. The crisp leaves of holly, mistletoe, and ivy reflect back the light as if so many little mirrors are scattered here. And a mighty blaze goes roaring up the chimney as if in that dull petrification of a hearth, there's never known such warm joy. Heaps up on the floor to form a kind of throne. There's turkeys, geese, game, poultry, brawn, great joints of meat, sucking pigs, long rings of sausages, mince pies, plum puddings, barrels of oysters, red hot chestnuts, cherry-cheeked apples, juicy oranges, luscious pears, immense roll cakes, and seething bowls of punch that made the chamber dim with their delicious steam. In easy state upon this couch, here I am, a jolly giant, glorious to see, bearing a glowing torch like Pence's horn, held up high, shedding light on you, Scrooge. Come in, and know me better, ma'am. Come in and realize the light and the warmth.
I am the ghost of Christmas to come. And what does your behaviour create, Ebenezer? Want and ignorance. The need of the child and the desire for knowledge can only be ignored at your peril. These are man's creation and they will inhabit your earth.
Hear me. I am not the man I was. I will not be the man I must have been, but for this night. Why show me all this if I am past all hope? Good spirit, your nature intercedes for me and pities me. Assure me that I may yet change these shadows you have shown me by an altered life. I will honor Christmas in my heart. And try to keep it all the year. I will live in the past, the present, and the future. And the spirits of all three will strive within me. I will not shut out the lessons that you have taught me. I'll tell you that I may undo the wrongs of my world.
Scrooge was better than his word. He did it all and infinitely more. And to the children of want and ignorance, he did not die. He was a second father. He became as good as a friend, as good as a master, as good as a man. As good as the old city knew, or any other good old city, town, or borough. Some people laughed to see the alteration in him. He let them laugh, and little heeded them. But he was wise enough to know that nothing ever happened on this world for good, at which some people did not have their fill of laughter. And knowing that such as these would be blind anyway, he thought it quite as well that they should wrinkle up their eyes and grin, as have the malady in less attractive forms.
His own heart laughed, and that was quite enough for him. He had no further dealings with spirit, but lived upon the total abstinence ever afterwards, and it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas well, if any man alive possessed the knowledge. May that be truly said of us, and all of us.
And so, as everyone observes, God bless us, everyone!
Oh, and I thought it was for me. The senior choir started our concert tonight singing O Holy Night. Miss Graham decided to do this after watching Home Alone as a child. However, she nearly had a holy fright when the music got delivered and she saw how difficult it was. Christmas would not be Christmas without a splash of Dickens and how Ebenezer and Scrooge discovered the true spirit of Christmas. The spirit of Christmas is alive and kicking here at BSKL. The proceeds from tonight's concert are going to fund a sixth form project during which they will help renovate a Myanmar Marines refugee centre, giving not just money, but their time and energy. The next piece is by the jazz band, and it's called Frost the Snowman. I didn't quite understand that. I've got something to do with a detective program in the UK. Mr. Murphy is going to conduct the jazz band, and I asked him if he could tell me who's likely to be playing the soloists tonight. And he said, well, I haven't got a clue. It'll happen on the night. So I guess playing in a jazz band is a bit like Christmas, full of surprises.
Thank you. Thank you.
We now start the joy of all Christmas concerts. Furniture removal. You just heard the junior wind play, band-aid play, scat cat swing, and jingle bells. Amazingly, the junior wind band was formed just a couple of weeks before half term. And all of the children are playing their instruments in pips and sips lessons. They had their debut this week in assembly, and tonight they're playing in front of a big audience. So I can only assume that by next week they'll be on a world tour. You then heard the senior string group play Divertimento in D by Mozart. Mozart is never easy, is a cliche of course, but so true nevertheless. To verbalize the challenge of playing it is as much a challenge in itself. In most cases, that music would have been composed as background music, which is a somewhat unsettling thought for someone like me who is allergic to background music that no one's listening to. So I guess that piece by Mozart could be described as 18th century elevator music before elevators were invented. Three of the children in that group have been awarded the Allegro Award. This is an award for children that only have six or pips lessons, and they are allowed, because they've made such excellent progress, they're allowed to take their instruments home to practice on the weekend and during the holidays. Lillian, Ying and Yu Ying are all three recipients of this award, and we've seen a significant rate in the progress they have made. You are now going to hear, when everybody's in place, the Year 1 and 2 choir. They're going to sing A Million Little Snowflakes by Teresa Jennings. And this was written in response to the tragedy at Sandy Hook Elementary School in Connecticut in 2012, and the outpourings of love and solidarity within the community that followed. Snowflakes were used to decorate the walls of their new school. They were sent by people from all over the world until literally they had a million snowflakes. Rock and Roll Snowman is about a snowman and his aspirations to stardom, just like I would imagine some of the people that are singing. The training orchestra behind me are children who have only been playing for about a year in pips. This is one of their first ensemble experience, and as you can see, it's taken a lot of organization, getting cellos in the right place and walking with your instruments and sitting down with them. It all takes skills that you've never learned before. They're going to play a seriously simple samba, which is a simple piece with an underlying distinctive rhythm. Although I am not sure that for an 8-year-old, playing a samba is simple at all. Hairy Scary by Sarah Watts is their other piece, which they only started recently. And it's not actually as the music was really first intended to be played. Because as we all know, Miss Leng is a viola player. And viola players tend to hang around with musicians. She's not going to get me in public, so I can say that. And in most cases, the first violins have all the solos. But Miss Leng has rearranged this so that everybody gets to play the solo. Yeah.
Thank you.
We just heard the brass ensemble perform Carol of Bells. And the brass ensemble is another new formation that happened just before half term. The Carol of Bells was arranged by our own Mr. Sanchez. And when he told me they were going to play it, my immediate reaction was ambitious. However, the joy of having a team of extremely talented interns who could arrange the music to suit the playing abilities of each individual member of the ensemble. The senior wind band then performed Deck of Oars with Rock and Roll and Zia. In the rehearsal, one of our percussionists was ill. Ian was off school. So I got told, right, you're going to have to do it. I said, what? Play the rain stick. And I thought, oh, the rain stick is easy. You just turn it upside down and then turn it up the other way. How wrong can one music teacher be? The things that some of these children do, we don't often realize what skills are needed. The senior strings will play the Nutcracker, which is a typical Christmas story, the story of a little girl who receives a nutcracker in the shape of a soldier. And she falls asleep and dreams that all the presents come alive and fight against the Mouse King and his minions. Following that, you'll hear the primary choir. The primary choir rehearsed during enrichment during the week, and they will perform African Noel. There will then be a commercial break, but not the usual kind of commercial break. But I'll tell you about that when we get there. go home to the UK and watch television, my sister always fast forwards the adverts. And I say, no, don't fast forward the adverts. I never see them, I like them. And, but I'm sure you're going to really like this commercial break as well. Irina and Camille are going to sing a song from Little Shop of Horrors. In March, Mrs. Avery and her team will be staging the secondary production, and we would like you to put the dates in your calendar. Check your calendar, put the dates in, because I'm sure it's going to be very impressive. So Irina and Camille are just going to give you a little taste of what's to come.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me, Seymour. Feed me all night long.
That's right, boy. You can do it.
Feed me, Seymour.
Feed me all night long.
Shot on Jack Ma. How about a day with Hedy Lamar? You gotta get in. I'd be a big wheel, dining out every meal. I'm the man that can make it all real. You gotta get in. I'm your genie, I'm your friend, I'm your willing slave. Take a chance, just feed me in. You know the kind of eat, the kind of red hot treat, the kind of sticky, the sweet star brave. What if you want, don't be a puss. I feel like a Shirley Rival, cause show a little difference in the way that it does. Get it?
I don't know.
Like a Harley machine,
now you're
turning around like I was Jinxie,
no.
Making all the guys on the corner be green.
Oh, get it.
If you wanna breathe profound, then you gotta justify. Take a breath and look around. A lot of folks deserve to
die. It isn't very hard to see. Stop and think it over, pal. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me. The guy sure looks like plant food to me.
So nasty, treating her rough, turning her around and always talking so tough.
You need blood and he's got more than enough.
I need blood and he's got more than enough.
You need blood and he's got more than enough.
Go get it.
Miss Graham's not actually my servant. I just knew I wouldn't be able to reach it. It stands too high. You just heard the saxophone ensemble we're playing saxophone. As a music department in a very busy school, we quite often get asked to do things at lastminute.com. So when Mr. Murray came to see me this week and said the saxophone ensemble not ready to play, I had a sort of kind of major, minor meltdown. And I came in to watch them rehearse, and Mrs. Brock was watching them. And she commented on how strict and intensive the rehearsal regime is. But that's what gets results, intensive practice over a long period of time. Andy Scott wrote that piece of music, and I don't know whether some of you guys knew, but Andy Scott is a part-time goat farmer. At this point, the senior orchestra, which comprises of the strings and the wind, are going to play the academic overture by Brahms and Mars from the Planet Suite. But before we go, I'd like to do two things. I'd like to remind the training orchestra, the senior orchestra, and the wind band that because of all the overtime that you're putting in this week, there are no rehearsals tomorrow evening. And I'd like to invite any of you who feel the need to do your Christmas shopping. There will be children from school playing a different repertoire of music in one Utama on Saturday afternoon from 2 o'clock. I would like to thank my team, who are amazing. I'd like to thank Shona, Liam, Rachel, Ishmael, James, and John, Deirdre, Charlotte, and Louise. Louise played, she's a great one for us, when she played in the junior wind band, and she was as nervous doing that as I was turning the pages for Mr. Murray. I'd like to take this opportunity to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a peaceful New Year.
I would explain. That's my fault, not them. I get up to the stand and I go, how am I doing? What am I doing? And Emily Keane didn't go for the time. He met me just 5 feet and a half. And I forgot to get
up.
Thank you.